India needs to reinvent the way it does a lot of things.
400 million Indians still live in poverty in rural communities, are dependent on agriculture.
How do you really get more and more people interested in India to participate in the Indian growth story?
Each one of us in India works in a space where we're trying to make a change.
This is a government that has business in its blood. It's ready to listen, it's ready to understand what it has to do.
There are lots of good ideas, and how can they bring us into that policy creation as well as execution perspective?
Part of what I want to do here is to learn, is to share.
And the summit gives us a lot of ways in which this can be done.
So we've got issues of sustainability, we've got issues of urban-rural divide, we've got issues to do with climate change.
We need to create more entrepreneurs, a human resource space, which will not only be interested in getting employed, but also creating employment.
What India has is outstanding young people, outstanding executives.
Business leaders can go back with stronger mandates to invest in young people much earlier.
Once governments change their mindset, investors also are certainly going to be looking for a system which is fair.
For gender especially, it's not just a government issue, it's not just a private issue, it's an issue that affects everyone.
One of the things that I'd like to see gender equality do is being recognised as not just a nice to have, but a truly valuable thing to have.
We can use the new technology, the new political will, the new flow of capital.
We in the energy space are actually combining communication and computing power to improve efficiencies of wind turbines, and that's never been done before.
How do you make not only innovate technology, but how do you make them operate in a real farmer situation?
The session on food security was particularly important. Our focus has been to try to end hunger through commercial agricultural investment, to expand energy access through public-private partnerships.
By the year 2030, 50% of India will be in its cities, and we need to create jobs for these people.
It's only manufacturing that can actually create the number of jobs required to absorb this enormous population that's going to come out of agriculture.
And that's the reason why we want the globe to be connected with India, to come and really take advantage of that opportunity.
I came here wanting to ensure that the environment in which we invested was still there, and I leave convinced there's a very clear roadmap with the leadership moving forward.
There is a common future, and I think it's only together that we will find workable solutions.